हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम हियर इन सिक्स क्लास मैथ्स. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 5C ऑफ फ्रैक्शन. यस स्टूडेंट, इन दिस एक्सरसाइज वी विल लर्न हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट फ्रैक्शन ऑन द नंबर लाइन. हियर जस्ट लाइक इंटीजर्स, फ्रैक्शंस कैन ऑल्सो बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय पॉइंट्स ऑन द नंबर लाइन. यस, सम स्टेप्स आर हियर. Yes. First of all, we have to draw a line L and mark a point O on it. Label this point as O. Yes, zero. This point O will represent zero. Yes. Left hand side of this point O, we will take negative integers, negative fractions, and on right hand side of this point O, we will take positive fractions or integers. Yes. Then after this, select a unit of length in keeping with the denominator of the fraction. Yes. As you wish to represent. Now student, come to the exercise. Here, question number 1. Represent each of the following fractions on the number line. Yes. First part is here 1 upon 2. First of all, we have to check, is it positive or negative? This is positive fraction. That's why we will take this on right hand side of point O. Yes. To represent this, first of all, we have to draw a straight line. Yes. In center, we will mark a point O. And this will represent 0. Yes. Now we will take some points on left hand side and right hand side at the equal distance. Yes. Like this, OP will be equal to PA1. Yes. And one point also here. Now student, we have to represent 1/2. 1/2. For this student, I am taking here a point A on the right hand side. Yes, A1. Now student, we will divide this length from 0, means from O to A1, into two parts, because we have to take unit according to denominator. Here 2 is denominator, that's why we will divide this length OA1 into two equal parts. Yes. Here OP will be equal to PA. Yes. And this P will represent 1/2. Okay. Come to second. In second, we have to represent 2/3. This is positive fraction. Now student, according to this denominator 3, we will take a point on right hand side. Yes. I'm taking here A1. Yes. OA, here we will divide into 3 equal parts according to this denominator, which is 3. Yes. In this first part, will represent this one, 1/3, this second, 2/3, and this last one means 3/3. And we have to represent this 2/3, it means we will denote this by P. P represent here, represents 2/3. And distance will be equal between two points. Now student, come to this third part. Here 3/5. Yes, first of all, we have to draw a straight line, and here between this line we will take a point O which represent 0. Yes. On right hand side, I am taking here a point A1. Yes. And this distance from 0 to A1, we will divide into 5 equal parts. Yes. Now, this first is equal to 1 upon 5, second 2 upon 5, and this third 3 upon 5, this is 4 upon 5, and this A1, 5 upon 5 means 1. It means the required point is P. Yes, 3 upon 5 is represented by P. Highlight this required points and main points with dark circle or dark dot. Fourth, 5 upon 4. Yes, if your improper fraction, for this improper fraction it will be easy for us if we will convert this fraction into mixed fraction. On changing this, we are getting 1 whole 1 upon 4, means 1 plus 1 upon 4. Yes, to represent this on number line, first of all we will draw a straight line, and in mid we will take a point O, and on right hand side we will take a point A1 and A2 at equal distance. Yes, here OA1 is equal to A1 A2. Yes, distance will be equal. Now student, this distance between O to A, we will divide this according to our denominator, which is 4. In 4 equal part, we will divide this distance from O to A1. Yes. And here, after this 1, we have to take 1 upon 4. Then next distance, A1 to A2, we will divide this distance in next 4 parts, 4 equal parts. Yes, here this is 1 upon 4, this is 2 upon 4, this 3 upon 4, this 4 upon 4, and the next one is 5 upon 4. This is the required fraction, and required we will represent this fraction 5 upon 4 by P. Come to the second. Represent each pair of the fractions on the number line. First part of this question number 1 is 1 upon 4 and minus 1 upon 4. Means 1 is positive and second is negative. Positive fraction we will represent on right hand side of point O, and negative fraction we will represent on left hand side of point O. Yes. Now student, first of all we have to draw a straight line like this, and between this we will take a point O. Yes, this will represent 0. Yes, now I am taking a point A1 here on right hand side, and we will divide this distance from O to A1, 0 to A1, into 4 equal parts according to this denominator of positive fraction. Yes, now after dividing this, yes, first part represent 1 upon 4, second 2 upon 4, 3 upon 4, and this 4 upon 4. Yes, and the required fraction is 1 upon 4 of positive. This will represented by point P. Now come to this minus 1 upon 4. For this strength, we will take a point A1. Yes, the distance of this point from O will be equal to OA1. Yes, this is distance O minus A1 O is equal to O A1. Yes. Now student, this distance minus A1 to O, we will divide this distance into four equal part. Yes, this minus 1 upon 4, second part is minus 2 upon 4, third minus 3 upon 4, and this last is minus 4 upon 4, and the required fraction is minus 1 upon 4. We will represent this fraction by Q. Yes, required points are here P and Q. Yes, minus 4 and minus 1 upon 4. 1 upon 4 and minus 1 upon 4 represented by P and Q respectively. Second part. In the second part, 2 upon 5 and minus 2 upon 5. Yes, for this we will draw a straight line and between we will take a point O. Yes. On right hand side, I am taking a point A1. Yes. Now, this distance from O to A1, we will divide this distance into 5 equal parts. Yes, because their positive fraction is 2 upon 5. Which one has positive denominator? Yes, 5. Which is 5. Now, friend, first part equal to 1 upon 5, second 2 upon 5. This is 3 upon 5, 4 upon 5 and 5 upon 5. And we have to represent 2 upon 5. Yes. It means this is 2 upon 5 and this is represented by Q. Now, come to the next one, minus 2 upon 5. This point we will represent on left hand side of this point O. For this, we will take a point minus A1 and the distance from O to minus A1, we will divide this into 5 equal parts. Yes, this first part will represent minus 1 upon 5, second minus 2 upon 5, then this minus 3 upon 5, minus 4 upon 5, and the last point is this will represent minus 5 upon 5. And the required fraction is minus 2 upon 5. Yes, this fraction we will represent by P. Yes, P and Q are the required points. Rest part of this question number 1 and 2, you have to try yourself. Yes, student. Up to next video. Thank you.